Hi, I'm Whitney Morgan, Hashimoto's coach, functional medicine practitioner, and co-founder of the Functional Health Alliance. Welcome to another installment in my series where I answer some of the most common thyroid questions. If you haven't seen the previous videos in this series, I really encourage you to go back and check those out. I do cover a lot of ground regarding Hashimoto's, hypothyroidism, and just general thyroid health. Before we jump into today's question, make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit that little bell icon so you'll get notified every time I post a new video. The question I'll be answering today is, are thyroid nodules serious? This is an important question that I get often, particularly from my clients who have Hashimoto's. It's understandable to be concerned if you've been told you have thyroid nodules. And I've worked with dozens of women who share this concern. So let's break it down together. First off, let me reassure you that thyroid nodules are extremely common. In fact, around 65% of the population has them, whether they realize it or not. Thyroid nodules are particularly prevalent among women, especially those with Hashimoto's or hypothyroidism. So if you've been diagnosed with a thyroid nodule, know that you are not alone. Statistics show that women are about four times more likely to develop thyroid nodules, and about 30% of women in their 30s have a thyroid nodule. And by the time they're 50, most women have at least one thyroid nodule. But here's the good news. Research tells us that approximately 90% of all thyroid nodules are benign. That means that they are non-cancerous and usually don't require any aggressive treatment. Instead, most nodules are monitored through regularly scheduled ultrasound imaging, and if needed, a biopsy is performed to ensure that a nodule is not malignant. Now, let's take a deeper look into the different types of nodules. Not all nodules are the same, and knowing the type of nodule you have can help to guide treatment. Thyroid nodules fall into four basic categories. A multinodular goiter is an enlarged thyroid with multiple nodules. While usually benign, it can cause thyroid dysfunction, so hormone levels should be monitored regularly. Cystic nodules are fluid-filled nodules that are also usually benign. They may grow or shrink over time, but rarely cause any issues unless they become too large or painful. Inflammatory nodules form due to chronic thyroid inflammation, and usually this is because of autoimmune conditions like Hashimoto's. And these inflammatory nodules can vary in size. And finally, there are solid nodules, which are tissue-based nodules that can also vary in size. They're usually benign, but they can become cancerous. Particularly with these nodules, a fine needle biopsy may be required for further evaluation. Have you been diagnosed with thyroid nodules? If so, what steps are you taking to manage your thyroid health? Please share it with us in the comments. So, why do thyroid nodules happen in the first place? Well, they can occur due to a variety of different underlying factors. Chronic inflammation, often caused by autoimmune conditions like Hashimoto's, is a primary contributor. And then there are nutrient deficiencies like iodine, selenium, and vitamin D that can contribute to nodule formation. And then there are stressors like environmental toxins, pesticides, heavy metals that can disrupt thyroid function and encourage nodules to grow. Nodules can also form due to hormonal changes, like those during pregnancy or menopause. And some gut infections, like H. pylori, can disrupt thyroid function, causing nodules to form. Lastly, food sensitivities, particularly to gluten and dairy, can fuel thyroid inflammation, contributing to nodule development. So, to answer the question, are thyroid nodules serious? Most of the time, no. The vast majority of thyroid nodules are benign, but that doesn't mean they should be ignored. Regular monitoring, dietary changes, and addressing root causes like nutrient deficiencies or autoimmune conditions can go a long way toward managing them. If you've been diagnosed with thyroid nodules, I encourage you to work with a functional medicine practitioner to address some of these underlying issues. You do not have to navigate this alone. And remember, get your thyroid nodules checked regularly and prioritize your health. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and share it with anyone you think it might help. And don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell so you'll get notifications on new videos in this series. And if you're ready to take control of your thyroid health, head to the link below and schedule a qualifying call with me today. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.